The Palomino Express. The
Palomino Express, Michael Gunner and Ken Lacy. Did a great job again last night.
For the third game in a row, there's the Palomino that's a new addition.
It's old Buzz.
Buzz Bid, owned by the Sally family here in Tulsa.
Crum kicks the ball out of the end zone to start the ball game. Our defense is going to come out on the field. We want to hold them here and get good field position. They come out, Jerry, trying to run the football, but going into the ball game, West Texas State had thrown the football 77% of the time, so we did not feel like they were very good running football team.
One of the few passes they threw in the first drive, a little short pass to Bell, good for 6 yards.
We invite them to throw in front of us. We tell our linebackers, trade them a completion for a headache. They catch the ball, come up, knock them loose from the football. We're going to do this later on.
Number one is Victor McGee, their passer.
He's a good football player. Good football player out of Longview. We got a lot of football players go strong out of Longview.
Longview, Texas. Adrian Baker, 232-pound running back.
Big old running back, big strong back. Victor McGee, a lot of the fans may not know this, Jerry, was Kenny Jackson's backup quarterback in high school.
That's right.
Longview, Texas. Played defensive halfback in the junior college center. Come on, defense, get after it. I thought our pass rush last night was excellent, Jerry, when the ball game was in doubt. We'll throw a little quick out. We're playing man coverage. Robert Estes, number 32, in on the tackle. Fake draw, get over there, defense. Brian Burroughs knocks him out of bounds. Number 47, senior linebacker out of St. Louis.
They're going to try a field goal attempt, which is really pitiful. It's the only way to characterize it, into the wind.
Into the wind. I was a little bit surprised they kicked the field goal in that situation. We come out the first time we touch the football, hand it to Ken Lacy. I tell you, Lacy's doing a great job. Lacy's, of course, a senior football player and does a great job running with his eyes. He runs to daylight.
Lacy got 9. Michael Gunner got 7 there.
First down on the toss sweep to Mike Gunner. Here's Ken inside for about 4 or 5 more yards. As we mentioned earlier, they started out here trying to play us in an 8-man front. It's going to take us a little while, but we're going to adjust to get them off balance. We'll
Jim Strong, out. Receivers coach. There's one of your players.
And a little sprint out pass right there and hit the flanker inside in the hole.
David Hershey in the first down. Boy, that's good. That's a good offensive line charge right there. John Kaspersky, left guard, 867. Watch him. Had a defensive tackle on his back. Really, really playing good football.
A skip ass coming right into the camera. Big play to Lacy.
Good job, Ken Lacy, running north and south. 210 pounds of dynamite. Look at that cut. Boy, I tell you, that's good offensive line play. That's Steve Cox again at right guard, number 58. David Imes, the center, number 54. Siddle Bramwich, number 79. Right tackle, John Kaspersky, the left guard. And David Pearson, the left tackle, number 7.
So we're up 7-0. We're going to pick up just a couple of plays in their next drive because it doesn't last long. They're going to have to punt the football, and Tulsa's going to come storming again.
We're going to come storming. Bulldog is going to make a fair catch. Number 15, Brent Dennis. No, he isn't going to fair catch. What am I talking about? He doesn't fair catch too many of them.
No, he doesn't.
Mike Gunner on the toss sweep. Watch old Mike make him dodge. Carried the ball 11 times for 140 yards.
Got 25 of them on that, that carry, coach. Lacy, 7.
We talked earlier coming out here, Jerry, Coach Strong and I. We give the defenses a lot of problems. We're going to run some double tight end. We're going to run a pro set. We're going to run a twin set. We're going to mix our play action passes in real good with a running game. And I tell you, it puts a lot of burden on the defensive football team.
Never touch.
Boy, this is a beauty. This is a beauty.
Come with a play action pass. We've been running the football off of a hard dive. We run the hard dive fake, and the corner sticks his nose up in there, and we just run the flanker right by him for touch. Excellent throw by Skip Ash.
Great execution.
We're going to let them throw an interception to Joe Blankenship here, and I get the ball right back.
Joe Blankenship really worked hard on his pass drops this week. Number 84 out of Spiro, senior defensive end out of Spiro, Oklahoma.
Come with a quick out right there. Probably should have caught that football on a quick out. Good throw by Skip Ash. Skip really had an excellent game throwing the football last night.
Oh, he sure did.
Skip missed about 2 days of practice last week, and we were really pleased with his execution. Usually when you don't practice very much during the week like that, Jerry, you don't play well on Saturday, but Skip is a real competitor.
We change ends of the field. This is pretty
tough. This is a beauty. Counter option. We call the play number 28. Skip's going to fake the ball into the line to Mike Gunner. He draws a crowd and bring the ball on the corner, kick it out to Lacy, and Lacy walks in for a touchdown.
21-0, and we're going to skip way on down here in the second period again. Watch the defense.
Get after him. That's James Dunlap, number 93. I tell you, Dunlap can really run, number 93.
Pass completion and then a fumble. Here we're going to get the ball back again. Boy, what a hit.
Bob Babish, number 62, knocks him loose from the football. Can't see who came up
with the ball. Ryan Burroughs came up with
the ball. Ryan Burroughs, number 47, came out of the pack with the ball.
We're going to punt it back to them now and then pick up their next possession. In the second period, Tulsa leading 21-0 now.
21-0. Get after him, defense. Get after him, defense. Good pass rush. Kevin Lilly, 77, in on the bottom of the pile.
He and Brian Bruner.
Brian Bruner, 96, two sophomore defensive linemen right here at home out of Tulsa, Oklahoma.
They put a couple of fresh backs in the ball game. This is a fellow by the name of Gist on this run.
The Bulldog makes a tackle, number 15, Brent Dennis. Defense really is improving, Jerry, as the year goes on. They're all young. Most of them are going to come back next year, except our linebackers and Joe Blankenship, defensive end. Kelly Beasley, number 43, is a senior.
And Dennis, good coverage on that
safety.
Last play.
This is good coverage. Coach Kane worked real hard all week long on keeping the ball in front of us, and I thought our first defensive secondary really played well.
So they got to punt the ball away again. Goes into the end zone with the wind at their back.
Take it and go score offense. We're going to take over on the 20. Let's do some damage. Tall sweep. Jerry, watch this play. Watch this next play coming up. I believe it's the next play when Mike Gunner's going to carry the guy for about 20 yards.
Yeah, I think it's maybe the play after this.
Hard dive.
Now here we come.
First down.
Here we come.
Watch it, Mike. He's going to get hit right here on the 26-yard line. This guy's holding on.
What a free ride.
I think he'd have scored, Coach, if that guy hadn't cut his legs up, money.
Something people might not realize and understand, Michael Gunner has the strongest leg strength than anybody on our football team.
Replay. Now, watch this. Watch how he's going to get 44 yards on this carry, and he just plays piggyback here.
Get on his back here now so I can carry you. Mike is going to carry him for about 20 yards. Number 24 is the first team free safety now for West Texas.
That's funny looking. He cannot get him down. Mike.
That's a great run, Mike. That's a great run. Mike has really worked hard. He's had a great year for us.
Getting a hug.
See how close we are. The offensive football team, real close. Here's Ken Lacy.
He gets 10.
This is called Rip City, Jerry. We're handing the football off, running inside. Coach Hollis got that offensive line jacked up.
Just marching here.
David Ives, we look to you. Sometimes you can highlight some of these films. I know Cox in one particular play this morning, Coach Stone, I was looking at earlier, he had a guy right on his back about 10 yards downfield. Steve Cox is having a fantastic season for him.
28-0 now. We're still in the second quarter.
28-0. Let that old horse roll a little bit. I bet he got tired running around last night.
He probably had a couple of extra bales of hay after that game, I guarantee.
That's a great sight, though, carrying the hurricane flag around the field. He borrowed that flag from Donnie Kerberg. I talked to Donnie last night. He didn't have a flag to wave up in the stands. They worked on it every day because they'd done this against Florida.
They kicked three onside kicks against Florida, and like Coach says, we spent quite a bit of time during the work week, during practice, trying to cover that with our young people.
We were concerned at halftime, Jerry. We're leading Drake, I think, 24-0 at halftime and came out and did not play very well the second half. We lead New Mexico State, I think, 27-0 at halftime. The same thing happened. So we want to go out the second half and impress the bowl people and roll up some stats and get a chance to have an easy ball game and play an awful lot of young football players.
McGee's scrambling.
McGee's scrambling here, and we're going to get a 15-yard personal foul penalty here. They hit us, and then after the whistle, and we retaliate, and that's always what happens. When you hit late like that, you're going to get called.
Pass to their tight end coming up. He's their leading receiver, their tight end.
Pretty good football player. They did a pretty good job throwing and catching the football in the films we'd broken down going into our ballgame. Bob Babbage, 62. Brian Burrows, 47. Two linebackers right there is what I'm talking about.
Yep. The guy that strikes second gets caught.
Counter dive and stopped at the line of scrimmage. Rogers Hayden in the nose guard now, number 49. Here's their touchdown. Victor McGee, good athlete, number one.
Now, it's 28-7. It becomes important that you don't let them back in, that you come right back and answer.
That's exactly right, and that's exactly what we did, Jerry. We got our first offensive team back in the ballgame. I didn't understand why they onside kicked the last time. On that last touchdown, we had a holding penalty, and we get a 10-yard penalty, so they kick off from the 50-yard line.
Mike Linsley gets 35 yards.
Mike Gunner comes out there and tells them who's boss in the second half, number 22. Good blocking downfield. Steve Cox, Bramwich, Kurt Stein, our number 80 tight end.
Skipper gets about four.
Skip did a great job again last night, Coach. Coach Strong directing our offense.
They get a face mask penalty here. I'll
tell you something we might mention right here, Jerry, is we come in and we go with two tight ends. They're playing four defensive backs in a football game. We come in with a two tight end look, and we move the football right down the field.
It's a great cut by Ken Lacy. Great block downfield right there.
We're really ready.
David Hersey, I don't know if we have a replay of this or not, but if we do, watch number 82. Watch 82 at the top of your screen. He's going to take out two people right there.
Yeah, he did.
Just knocked, just ran right over him. David Hersey weighs about 220, doesn't he, Coach?
He's 220, 225. That's what wears him down. He needs to lose a little bit of weight.
We got to run him a little bit more, David. If you're watching the show this morning, now we got to get you in shape. Old Buzz there.
Here comes a touchdown.
Galloping around the field, skip pass, takes it in the end zone for a touchdown behind the right side of our offensive line.
35-7, Tulsa just answers immediately, and by now, you know, the ball game is well under control.
Control. We're going to start playing an awful lot of young football players. Of course, we play a lot of young players on defense the whole ball game anyway. That's a good break on the football there. Brent Dennis, number 15. James Dunlap chasing the ball, number 93.
Incomplete.
Steve Ford, 66. Junior defensive ends having a fine year for us.
Another incompletion. And they're going to punt, and here comes the punt return.
Punt return. Again, watch a great block. I hope we can see Timmy Gibbs here, right? Boom, he took out the first guy down.
Mm-hmm.
We got a good wall set up. And again, Jerry, we work real hard on this in practice every day. Down the sideline, Bulldog. Put the ball on the 4-yard line. I think we're going to score the first play. We're going to put in Scott Brown, Coach Strong, and throw the 147 pass.
We throw the goal line pass right here, Jerry. We've got a guy out there that's 6'3". They've got a 5-foot, 10-inch cornerback. Tell our quarterbacks just to lay it up, and Scott does. Throws a great football, and it really makes it easy for the receiver to make the catch.
Scott does a great job throwing that particular pass. Puts a little touch on it.
Point after, makes it 42-7. Stu Crum almost wore his leg out kicking extra points last night.
Kicked 8 last night, Jerry. Of course, every time he kicks one, now it's a new school record. Stu also set a conference record last night, 16 field goals in a season. Deep onside kick, and we recover the ball. Who came out of the pile? Tony Buford, 41. I told him Tony does a great job on special teams.
Really does.
Freshman out of St. Louis.
Johnny Horton, the ball carrier.
Yeah, Johnny Horton at running back. Eddie Hamilton, number 16 at fullback. Here comes Eddie on the corner.
Got about 6.
And the counter option out to our twin set.
Eddie for another yard or so.
We're going to throw the screen, I believe, here, Jerry, coming up. It's going to be really a well-executed football play.
See, I think that's on the next series.
Coach, this series,
we're going to kick the field goal on this one.
We're going to kick the field goal. Stu Crum's going to set a new conference record here with his 16th field goal. What a great year Stu's having.
I think, Jerry, something that characterizes young football players on our team, you know, when we put them in a football game, we expect them to go ahead and move the football, move the chains. And the defensive side of the ball expects them to play great defense and just continue to put the pressure on the opposing football team.
The only way to get anybody is to go out there and compete every day in practice, lay it on the line and get better, work hard. That's why we're winning right now. Those guys, Skip Bass is the best example of that, Coach Strong. Skip played very little as a junior. I think he got in 3 ball games. He's worked real hard, and Coach, of course, came back as a senior, just having a fantastic season.
45-7 now, and they're going to give the ball, I think, right back. Yeah, they're going to give it right back to Tulsa.
They're going to give it right back to us here. Our defense is going to get great field position for us. We get the ball. I can't tell who created the fumble.
Estes winds up getting a recovery.
Yeah, he comes out over the pack. Jerry, he carries the ball off the field. And they're going to penalize us 15 yards here, give us a first and down and 25 situation because Estes Robert brought the ball off the field. Now, you see that happen all the time in football. It's the first time I've ever seen that play, that call.
Freshman William Oliver's in. Something bad going to happen.
Step and throw, William. We're going to throw the post pattern and get it intercepted.
Come a little play action pass, and the free safety steps over in front of it. And those things are going to happen sometimes. You can throw the football, you're going to get an interception every now and then.
They don't move it, though, and they got to punt it again.
That's the beauty of playing these young football players in these situations, Jerry. Hopefully, the only way you're going to learn is to get in the ball game, and hopefully we won't make that same mistake again.
We're going to drop down, Coach, now and pick up that play you're talking about, that little screen to Horton later in the third
this
period.
This is a beauty. We're a little bit reluctant to throw the football when we're leading this much, so we call a read screen. Look to the tight end. If he's open, hit him. If not, dump the ball off your back in the flat.
And he got close to the goal line.
Johnny Horton, sophomore running back out of Alabama.
Coach had an excellent block that time on a screen play by Tony Leapard. Got the kick-out block and allowed the back to jump back inside and then break it back out.
Tony,
a big game.
Tony did a good job on that play. Young sophomore lineman.
52-7. We're going to move down into the fourth quarter now. Pick up Tulsa again.
Here's the play I'm talking about. That's Kurt Steinauer over the middle.
Exact same play that we just hit the running back on. That time we threw the football to the tight end.
Skip 2 plays, pick up Rodney Young.
Rodney Young had a good night for us last night. He's going to be a fine football player, really aggressive football player, number 46. Another fine football player out of Tyler, Texas.
Another pass to the tight end, Kurt Steinauer.
Kurt had a good night catching the ball last night.
Here's Rodney Young again, Coach.
Rodney Young.
Tell you what, that's really a credit to the offensive line, and those are some of the young offensive linemen in there. I tell you, those guys are coming off the football and putting a hat on them and getting a lot of movement at the point of attack.
They're playing Tony Leaphart and Pat Maley at center, Tony Leaphart at guard, Chad Muirhead at right guard out of Bishop Kelly High School.
Pick them up again just to show our defense here, Beasley.
Fine play by Kelly Beasley. Fine play by Kelly Beasley, number 43, senior free safety out of Bristol. Get after him, defense.
Brent Dennis breaks this one up. Got good
playing
coverage.
Man coverage, got a pretty good rush in that particular situation. Brainer linebackers.
They miss a field goal.
Jerry, why would you kick a field goal when you're getting beat 52-7? I don't understand that.
We tried to figure that out up in the broadcast booth. Couldn't. And let's see here. Going to pick up Eddie Hamilton.
Eddie Hamilton.
He's got the quick feet.
Get up, Phil, Eddie. Number 16, William Oliver, quarterback, Eddie Hamilton, Johnny Horton. We're going to get Benny May in the ball game. We give him a touchdown here, Jerry. We throw him the football. They're going to take it first play and score a touchdown here.
Of course, this is the game long since is over.
The game's over, but it's like Coach Strong mentioned. We don't want to go out there and play. Go out there and play like you practice. You practice good during the week, you play well on Saturday. We don't want those young players going out there and performing. Don't leave the ball in on the field.
And they, of course, going for the two-point conversion, 52-15. Late in the ball
Jerry,
game.
I hate. We give up an awful lot of cheap yardage here late in the ball game, and you hate to see that happen because it makes us look bad in terms of stats, you know. But I guess stats are for losers. We're worried about one thing, that's winning the ball game. We're still playing a lot of young players. The ball game is over. It's been over a long time now, but they're going to come back and get another touchdown on us.
We got a play coming up here that I like a lot, Kirk Phillips.
Little play action pass right there. We call it off of the 28. That's 128 right there. We hit the split end. He releases outside the cornerback, and Scott Brown throws a nice ball and makes it easy again for the receiver to catch.
Although Kirk has not caught a lot of passes, he's had an outstanding season for him.
Eddie Hamilton goes 21 yards.
Eddie Hamilton
yards
on the hard
touchdown.
Dive, taking in for a touchdown, Eddie.
59-15.
Jerry, we thought about going for 2 points right there. Gil Swall sent word down that since we've been here, I guess, we've only scored 59 points is the most points we've ever scored. We thought about going for two, Coach.
Set the record last year against Drake, and I tell you what, I was tugging on Coach Cooper trying to get him to go for it. Too nice a guy, Jerry.
Yeah.
He didn't want to go for two.
Well, we're going to have to play this West Texas team down there next year, Jerry. Here's a cheap touchdown to end the ball game.
You know, we threw that in because this young man had caught that pass.
He can fly.
He can fly. I think he's a conference 440 champion or something
good.
Like that.
He is. He can really fly. And I say this, Coach Davis, Don Davis, our head football coach, is a real gentleman after the ball game. I hope he didn't feel like we're trying to run a score up because we played everybody that was suited out, everybody that we're not going to register.